Yeah, I look better. Please remain standing for our national anthem and the Pledge of Allegiance.
Thank you.
pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Please be seated. My name is Melanie Cerrone. I am the president of Wheaton High School's class of 2017. It is my pleasure to introduce to you our honored guests that have joined us today. Please stand and be recognized. Our counselors, Ms. Stephanie Powell, Ms. Marsha Bestminer, Ms. Nikki Harkin, Ms. Shannon Holliday, Ms. Pauline Matthews, Ms. Maureen Ponce, and Mr. Scott Wu. Our class officers, Vice President Sanjuni Fernando, Treasurer Emily Delson, and Secretary Mahitsub Solomon. Our student speaker, Shayla Santiago. Our staff speaker, Mr. Marvel. To my left, our administrators and executive staff, Dr. Deborah Muggy, our principal, the Honorable Ms. Ortman Faust, Board of Education member, Dr. Jack Smith, superintendent, Dr. Daryl Williams, Associate Superintendent of Secondary Schools, Dr. Deborah Monk, High School Director of School Support and Improvement, Dr. Jim Berry, Assistant Principal, Ms. Heather Carias, Assistant Principal, Ms. Sandy Spruill, School Business Administrator, Mr. Don Reed, Assistant School Administrator, and Ms. Sandy Williams, Assistant Principal and Senior Class Administrator. I also want to thank the leaders of our cluster schools that are with us. Thank you for supporting us in building the foundation that led us to today. Ms. Nicole Sosick-Loiderman, Ms. Zoraida Brown Sergeant Shriver, and Mr. Matt Hawkins Veris Mill. Welcome to the Wheaton High School Class of 2017 graduation. I would like to thank, on behalf of my peers, the staff and families who made this day possible. On August 26, 2013, we entered through those old black Wheaton doors, not ready for what the next 4 years would hold. We walked through the busy hallways with the intimidating seniors looking down on us, rushing to get to our homeroom class. The old building holds most of our memories that we will forever cherish. It's where we first learned what it meant to be a Wheaton Knight. Plus, we all have to appreciate that one free day we got to sleep in because of those old broken pipes. Today, however, we are the very first school to graduate from the new school building after an entire academic year. This new space is where we brag to our friends about those fancy Promethean boards, our high school musical stairs in the cafeteria, and how we actually had space to walk in the hallways. These transitions challenged us, but together we grew. Every year for homecoming week, our class has decorated the hallways to win competitions against other classes. Most memorable was Money Wars, where we raised over $1,200, defeating the seniors on our last day of the competition when a student in our class donated $100. Our school spirit and pride grew again when our football team beat Watkins Mill in the playoffs last year after not winning a game in the playoffs for 10 years. We are a class that has made history, we are a class that is powerful, and we are a community which has grown together over the years to accomplish amazing things. However, we know this journey was not always easy. No matter where we came from or the journey it took, we are all here today to celebrate our achievements. We all stressed over challenging courses and tried to balance the demands of our social life with chores and late evening studying for exams. Some nights, I even thought to myself I wouldn't be able to succeed, that I wouldn't make it to this very moment. But with the support systems at Wheaton and others in our lives, we managed to push through so that we could all be sitting here ready to walk across the stage. Because of our education, we are prepared to leave bright futures, whether that means heading off to college, the military, volunteer service, or entering the workforce. However, this milestone in our life is only the beginning, and walking across this stage is the key to unlocking our potential. As we leave high school behind us and step into our adult life, I urge you to remember we are always Wheaton Knights, no matter where our lives go. I give you all my best wishes, and I am proud to say that we finally made it.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Sandini Fernando. I'm the Vice President of the Class of 2017, and I'll be introducing this year's student graduation speaker. This year, we chose Shayla Santiago to speak to and represent the senior class. Now, a little bit about Shayla includes that she has been in the Engineering Magnet program since ninth grade. She has been on Wheaton High School soccer team, cheer, and in indoor track. Some of the clubs that she has partaken in include the National Honor Society, SGA, and Drama Club. And from personally knowing her, I know that she is an amazing person. Just last year, when we had a book drive in NHS, Shayla was one of the first students who brought in a box full of books to donate to our community's libraries. She has done so much for SGA, from helping to set up pep rallies, to participating in them, showing her school spirit, and helping to plan events at school. She's an active member of the Wheaton High School community. As for Drama Club, she's an excellent actress and has contributed to several of our school's productions. Her favorite class during high school was having Principles of Engineering with Mr. Segris because she loved the hands-on experiences that she had in class, and she found Mrs. Segris's funny and caring persona unforgettable. Her love for engineering carries on with her into the future as she plans on attending Texas Christian University in Fort Worth, Texas this fall to study mechanical engineering. The reason that she wanted to address the senior class for graduation was because she wanted to remind us all one last time before we walked out those doors and into our futures that, and I quote, "We can make the world a better place by tolerating and supporting one another before we step into the real world." Now with that, it is my great pleasure to welcome Shayla Santiago onto the stage.
Good afternoon, friends, family, staff, and my fellow Knights. My fellow Knights, congratulations. You've not only survived high school, but you've managed to fight senioritis long enough to get your diploma. We all did, and we all did as Knights. I know it's graduation, so I'll spare you all the history lesson, but here's a little background on what it means to be a Knight according to history. The medieval knight was considered to be an officer in the Greek or Roman army. Each knight was a highly trained soldier who fought mounted on a horse. These individuals were esteemed for their ability to fight on horseback and known for being educated in the arts. They were model citizens for society, following the strict rules and obligations deemed by their orders. And while these are true facts based on historical accounts, there are things that are specific to Wheaton Knights. I invite all of you, friends, family, and staff included, to look to your left and then to your right. If you have done as I suggested, you will see that the Wheaton community, us, is made up of many varying communities. Our education is our training. Our teachers, mentors, families, and friends make our horse. They don't let you fall flat on your face. Unless your teacher did her makeup in class or made you watch YouTube videos in place of class lectures, then you probably got dirt in your mouth a couple of times. But the majority of the people who have enlightened us on this path to success have helped lift us up in some way. They've helped shape the armor that we will soon share with the world. An armor that has come from a lack of discrimination and a surplus of love, with the hope that we young people will make a difference in this world. A hope that we will take the skills we've learned and the experiences we've had in these short, very short, 4 years, and apply them to life. These skills include the ability to speak publicly, solve problems, take risks, lead, analyze data and environments, and so much more. But the most beautiful skill Wheaton has given us is the ability to work with a diverse group of individuals to accomplish a common goal. We will come across people from all walks of life in college and in the workplace. Being able to tolerate and accept people of varying backgrounds, beliefs, and cultures will enrich not only our school and work environments, but also our lives. Even though under the home we are all different, with our armor on side by side, we are all knights, Wheaton knights. And that's something to be proud of no matter how far you go or how close you stay to this community. Our community, have no fear. We are young, strong, and proud. Be proud of where you come from, and there will be no obstacles, no bounds that can hold you back. They can't even chip the armor this community has molded for you. Wear it in trust that you are accepted for who you are and that this community will never turn its back on you. I want to end my speech with a special thanks to Dr. Muggy for not only giving me the opportunity to be a mentee in the First Lady's Leadership and Mentorship Program under Michelle Obama, but for never turning her back on me. And to my parents, for loving me at my best and at my worst. I would not be the person standing before you today if it were not for their strength, expectations, and vision. Forever, Wheaton Knights.
Hi everyone, my name is Emily Dulcid, and I've had the honor to serve as treasurer for the class of 2017. Each year, the senior class elects a staff speaker. This year, our selected teacher has been a favorite amongst our class since most of us were freshmen. This gentleman graduated from Morgan State University. He is a proud father of four. This is his fifth year at Wheaton High School, and he's been the wrestling coach for 4 years. People describe him as a hilarious, sassy, and a sarcastic person. They also say he is very dedicated, wise, inspiring, charismatic, and passionate. One student said, and I quote, "Mr. Marvel is a motivator. He always keeps it real and tries his best to let his students know how the real world is." I have the privilege to introduce Kola Wale O. Marvel Sr.
Before I get into this, I just want to say there was a lot of people questioning. I've been out for a little bit. I've been a little sick. You can probably even still hear it in the way I sound. And a lot of people ask me, well, oh, are you coming back? Well, are you going to make it? And there is no place anywhere else in the world that I'd rather be. Anywhere else in the world. All right, so on to it. Congratulations, class of 2017. You made it, and now you're off into the real world. But before you go, there's one thing that I need you to do. Think about it. Before you make that move, before you date that girl, before you quit that job, before anything else you think about it. All right? All of you, if there's nothing else you do in this life, remember to think. Think often, think well, think before, during, and after the fact. Use your thinking to order your steps and guide your path. It may sound easy, but the way things are set up today, it's almost easier for a person not to think. Just take a moment and think about it. You can think of at least three people you ran into today that probably never had a thought go through their mind. Just saying. Choices and thought has been simplified for people. Everything is reduced to a yes or a no or this or that. Even Netflix switched from 5 stars to a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Like, who does that? Diversity is dying. And with it dies choice and thought. There are many in this world trying to kill diversity. The easiest way to kill diversity is to make all things extremes. Extremes pretend to make decisions easier, but really, they make you miss out on life. You miss the beauty that lies in between the extremes, the beauty between the ups and the downs, the left and the right, the black and the white. You must live in the gray, the center, the middle. You must thrive there. You must think there. Think for yourself. Think about yourself. Think about your past, your future, but most of all, think about your present, your here and now. Think about your choices. Think about where you are, how you got there, and where you're headed next. Think and create questions. Question everything. Question even your own thinking. Let your thinking guide you to answers, and let those answers guide you through life. Now, some of those thoughts may leave you to a scary place and tough tasks. Don't be afraid to try. Many people never put forth true effort because they are afraid to fail. They're afraid of losing and becoming a loser. Losing does not make you a loser. Quitting does. That's something that you got to etch in your soul, right? You'll fall 1,000 times in this life, and I promise you, you will fall. Times will be hard. You will be alone for some of them. You will have people with you other times. But what measures you, what means something, is when you get up, how you get up, and that you always get up. You've heard all the stories, you know, Oprah got fired, Michael Jordan got cut, Einstein got held back in the first grade. But are they losers? Not at all. They became greats in their field because they pushed past that first failure. They pushed past that wrong thing that happened and moved on. Back to the thinking. Think about others. More so, think as others. Too often, people don't care about problems that don't affect them or don't affect someone they know. They close their eyes to the world and they cannot see past their own thoughts and beliefs. A blind man can see more than someone who closes their eyes. That was a little deep. Think with others. Knowledge comes from experiences. If you're the only gaining experiences from one perspective, you will never truly learn anything. You need diversity. Diversity is a mixture of differences, not just a majority of a minority. I'll say that one more time. Diversity is a mixture of differences, not just a majority of something that's usually a minority, all right? Diversity creates adversity. You learn nothing from being around a bunch of yes men. So don't just think alone. Think with your friends, think with your family, think with coworkers, colleagues, associates, even your enemies and your adversaries. Yes, I want you to think with people who don't think like you. I know that's a little weird. He's dumb over there. No, he's not dumb, he's just different. Figure out that difference. Right? Nowadays, folks argue just to be right instead of to figure out what is right. You need to think out loud with others who may or may not have the same thoughts as you. Those foreign thoughts may guide you to answers you've been looking for a long time. Sometimes you need to hear from someone else. Sometimes they need to hear your thoughts. Respect your thoughts. Your thoughts have value. Your thoughts are special. No one can think exactly like you do. You are the only you that there has ever been and that there ever will be. Digest that for a moment. No one else in this world is like you. You are special. You're all special. Everyone is special, right? But then on the other hand, saying that everyone is special is basically the same thing as saying no one is special. You're not more important than anybody else. You need to figure out, how do you fit into this world? How does this world fit into you? There is no set plan for everyone. Some people need college, some people don't. Some people need time, some people are ready. You cannot build your life based on everyone else's rules and success. You have to go out there and live your life. But as you live that life, pay attention. Learn and notice who you are. What do you like? What don't you like? What works for you? What drives you to be a better person each day? But most importantly, remember to think about it. Thank you very much for your time.
Good afternoon, students, family, and faculty. I am Hitab Solomon. I've been secretary for the past 3 years. It's been one of my high school highlights, participating in SGA. Being part of my class, I would have to say my most memorable moment from me in high school was a homecoming hallway decoration battle between the four other classes, which brought out creativity as well as competitiveness. It's been an honor being a classmate for the past 4 years, and I hope you guys have a prosperous journey in life. Now, I would like to introduce our very own Wheaton High School Philharmonic Orchestra, directed by Mr. Lauren Westbrook-Fritz, who will be playing the Peter Gunn by Henry Mancini with the clarinet solo by senior Kevin Legardo. Thank you.
Well, congratulations, class of 2017. You've made your first big milestone in your life, high school graduation. Most of you completed this journey in 4 years, but some of you might have taken a little more time, some might have taken a little less. What you all have in common is that you made it. It's really been a pleasure getting to know you these past 3 years. You have seemed to be a very easygoing class. So easygoing that for the past 3 weeks, I was afraid that some of you might not make it, but you did, so congratulations. I believe the students sitting in front of us today are the future. We have taught them well, and they are prepared to be the leaders of tomorrow. Hopefully, each student has a sense of pride for what they have accomplished. I know we are all so very proud of you. Each of you will take what you've experienced and move forward to the next milestone in your life. Rest assured, Wheaton High School has prepared you for college and career. Whichever path you take, go with confidence, knowing that you've got this. Along this journey, you've had the support of your family, friends, and yes, the Wheaton staff. This support does not stop just because you graduate. We will be there for you every step of the way. When things get tough, you will remember advice that was given to you. And when you celebrate success, you will remember every way to go and great job that you have heard during high school. We have all believed in you, and we knew you could do it. The students you see sitting in front of you have been awarded over $18 million in scholarships. And And I do want to say that one more time, because there's only 291 of you, and you have been awarded $18 million in scholarships. So give them a bigger round of applause. Sitting out here, there are 5 National Merit commended students, 2 National Merit semifinalists, 1 National Hispanic Program Scholar, and 1 National Merit Scholarship winner. Please give these students a round of applause. Here are just a few of the places graduation will be taking our students: Cornell, Columbia, Rice, Tulane, Spelman, Johns Hopkins, Howard, Hampton, Stevenson, Towson, University of Chicago, George Washington, Montgomery College, Michigan State, University of Maryland, University of Richmond, Trinity University, and also the Army and the Marines, and many, many more. As you leave today, please remember, the best way to predict the future is for you to create it. Thank you. It is now my pleasure to introduce our Board of Education member, Ms. Ortman-Faust. Ms. Ortman-Faust, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Wheaton High School, it is my great pleasure to present to you the class of 2017. I certify that they have met all the graduation requirements to qualify for a Maryland State High School diploma. Thank you.
I bring you greetings from my board colleagues and from our superintendent, Dr. Smith. I don't want to take too long, because when I finish, I say the magic words that turn you all into graduates. But I do have to take just a couple of minutes to echo some of the feelings that Shayla mentioned in her speech and recognize how important you and your school are to our world right now. We've been through a lot as a nation recently. There's been a lot of division and hate and fear based on assumptions that people make about others because of where they're from or what they look like or what they believe or who they love or what they have or don't have. But when I look at the students of Wheaton High School, students that come from every background, from all over the world, I don't see that division. What I see is what happens when differences don't foster fear. They foster compassion and understanding and respect and concern. You've seen what happens when you treat each other like you belong, like you're part of a family. You have a senior class that worked really hard to raise enough funds so that more of their classmates could afford to go to the senior prom. And you had a bigger turnout than ever before. And after an election that brought forth a lot of concerns for some of your classmates, you held welcome signs in front of your school the next day and passed out candy. Because you don't kick people out, you welcome them in. And you find ways to lift up each other's culture or learn more about your own culture, like by helping to start a club like the Black Student Union, like Kevin Hyla did. You decide you're not going to wait to make a difference. You're going to start right now, like Liam Kim and Daniel Owamato did, I will be voting for him for president someday. And you have a staff that urge you to get involved or have tremendous amount of spirit or win county awards like MCPS Rising Teacher of the Year, Ms. Morales, who celebrates culture in her Spanish class and sponsors the Latin Dance Club, or teachers that offered reassurance to their students on November 9th, like Mr. Scott, who said to his kids, "In my classroom, you're safe, you're welcome, you're loved. In this school, nothing has changed, and I'm here for you." What happens when people come together and believe in each other and believe the best about each other? You have awesome performances. Those little mermaids sang like angels. You have teams that give it their all for their team and get better and better every year. And I've seen that under Coach Marvel's leadership and Coach Trumbull and others, and it's amazing. So good job, teams. You have an amazing project-based learning showcase that's exceptional not only for its display of knowledge and deep research, but its demonstration of how well working together across differences is actually the best way to solve challenges and produce the greatest results. When I think about what I want for this country and what we as a board want from our schools, I think about everything that your senior class officers told me about this special place called Wheaton High School. And shout out to these wonderful woman leaders. Don't let your leadership stop with Wheaton High School. Just like you brought East Coast and West Coast hip-hop together for a Spirit Week display, you can be the force that brings us all together. You're the leaders we need for a new day, and I look forward to you using your talents, your imagination, your compassion and intelligence to make a difference. You don't have to do it tomorrow. You can sleep in tomorrow. But in whatever path you choose, remember, you know how to love. You know how to lead. Together, you are Wheaton. And 2017, class of 2017, I'm looking forward to you getting the heck out there and showing the world how it's done. And now, the magic words. By the virtue of the authority vested in the Board of Education of Montgomery County, under the laws of the State of Maryland, I do now award diplomas or certificates evidencing the satisfactory completion of prescribed courses of study to the students of Wheaton High School, who are recommended for graduation by the faculty of this school. In receiving this diploma or certificate, each of you is entitled to all the privileges and honors accorded to graduates of a high school accredited by the Maryland State Department of Education. Congratulations, class of 2017.
Melanie Cerrón. Sanduni Fernando. Emily Del Cid. Mahitab Solomon. Shayla Santiago. Felix Adams. Layla. Nyla Chowdhury. Brian Doe. Blake Kaufman. Kadia Lissett. Aurora McKenzie. Laura Pham. Sarah Rezai. Eric Wrong. Abhishek Shilpakar. Caitlin Ta. Jenny Tu. Neil Justin Yalung. Anthony Abuki. Temilolu Adefesan. Akwesi Ajman. Edwin Alfaro Marquez. Yeni Alfaro Marquez. Andrew Alfaro Beltran. Catherine Alfaro Cruz. Alexander Amaya. Alexander Amaya. Brian Amaya. Shanice Ambrose. Damon Anderson II. Beniam Assefa. Jamal Ateri. Juan Avelar Gomez. Megan Badu Yaboa. Kidus Bahiru.
Sandro Baisa.
Sandro Baisa Mendoza.
Say the last one.
Omar Bengura. Mara Barrow. Danielle Bartel. Harris Adam Balin. Evan Behrman. Yenene Bekele. Jordan Bell. Khalil Ben Yedder. Mohammed Ben Yusuf.
Good job, Ben Yedder. Mr. Ben Yedder, good job, man.
Ronnie Lopez. Ronald Benitez. Laura Benitez Fuentes. Claudia Bacecki. Brenda Bonilla. Arvin Brisson.
Good job, Brenda.
Andreas Caballero.
Good job, Mr. Brisson. Good job.
Cristian Barrera Cabrera. Andrew Caffey. Katin Kai.
Good job, Andrew.
Deontay Campbell. Marco Canjura.
Saul Carvajal Solórzano.
Claudia Cardona Ramos.
Claudia Cardona Ramos. Kaylin Casamajor. Matilde Chavez. Wendy Chavez Ramos. Kendra Clark. Jocelyn Cordero Alfaro. Brian Cortez Flores. Jordan Crawford O'Banner. Aliyu Creighton. Glenn Cross. Francisco Cruz Mira.
say this, De Silva Torres. Okay.
Good job,
Jose De Silva Torres.
Cynthia Davis.
Tashelle Davis. Eric Del Cid. Emmanuel Del Cid. Violeta De Lima. Tanae Dukley. Nicolas Duran. Jason Ejimogu. Juanita Elliott. Perry Ellis. Samantha Escobar. William Escobar. Melanie Fernandez.
Nimesh
Fernando. Naomi Fikramariam. Leslie Flores. Veronica Flores Fuentes. Wendy Flores Hernandez. Alexander Fuentes. Alexis Fuentes. Ingrid Fuentes. Jasmine Fuentes. Nina Fuller. Sophia Gamboa. Luis Garcia. Adriana Gill. Salamawet Girma. Robinson Hiron. Sydney Gladden.
Clark Justin Glory.
Clark Justin Glory. Francisco Gomez Blanco. Alexander Urquilla. Benjamin González. Valeria González. Alejandro Grandes. Darlene Guardado. Deja Hackett Colet. Heaven Hyla. Galila Halamariam. Angelo Holloway. Delonte Henderson Feist. Maria Hernandez. Virginia Hernandez. Irwin Hernandez Aguilar. Denisha Hedge. Marneva Hines. Miho. Morris Hodge III. Mustaf Abraham. Luke Inman. Sandra Itzep Espinosa. Max Johnson. Travis Johnson.
Sabrina Johnson.
Sabrina Johnston. Daima Jordan. Kamal Khan. Liam Gil Kim. Quinlan Kimball Brown. Tauhee King. Erika Lara. Fernando Lara. Jason Lara. Christopher Lastadia. Maron Glegacy. Aranindu Linagay. Fernando Lopez. Francisco Lopez. Jennifer Lopez Amaya.
Melanie Lopez Cervantes.
Melanie Lopez Cervantes.
Francis Lowry.
Francis Lowry. Edwin Lugo Flores. Bashai Lingog. Gustavo Martinez. Maria Maynard. Brandon Mendina. Marco Mendina Ceballos. Carlos Mendrano. Yeah. Marina Mejia. Catherine Mejia Gonzalez. Ever Mejia. Hilda Mejia. Aiden McCoria.
Kevin Legardo. Guadalupe Quiroz. Christian Reynolds. Reina Melgar. Ronald Mendoza Diaz. Ingrid Menjivar. Tanya Mira Garay. Daquan. Daquan Mitchell. Christian Montano. Carlos Montaz. Daris Morales. Natalie Morales. Jamie Morban. Eric Moreno. Eric. Gabriel Moreno. Amir Mulugeta. James Mulamba. Ivan Rodrigue Mondo. Mark Nashuat. Arthur Ganu Pascual. Peter Nguyen. Woo! Stephen Nguyen. Toan Nguyen. Marvin Nolasco. Brian Nolasco Flores. Daniel Novoa. Lindsay Nunez. Justina Wegua. Alan Nirgesh. Analuchi Okori. Eni Omotosho. Emilio Orellana. Mark Organo. Ibuka Osinachi. Carlos Osorio. Samira Waydrago. Tatiana Payden. Maureen Panhunar. Anugraha Paul. Michelle Paredes. Joel Parks. Natalia Peña de la Rosa. Elizabeth Perez. Benaja Peer. Julie Peligua. Clark Pineda. George Polanco. Marvin Posada. Yeah. Luis Puma. Miriam Quintano Claros. Talia Quinteros. Ingrid Ramos Ramirez. Jonathan Ramos. Daniel Ramos de Leon. Tyler Reed. Katie Funes Reyes. Christian Reyes Ochoa.
Yeah, Christian!
Jose Villarosa. Jose Rivera. Brianna Roche. Destiny Robert. Elvin Rodriguez. Cindy Romero. Hernan Romero. Mauricio Romero. Aníbal Romero Jr. Carmen Rosales. Franklin Rubio. Kevin Sajonero. Eric Sanchez. Melanie Sanchez Soto. Chantel Saunders. Ever Saravia Guerra. Amelia Sayon. Eric Scott. Jason Scott. Adelowitz Seisibe. Tasnim Sharif. Johannes Schifferah. Gabriel Alexander Silva. Jason Solano. Griselda Solis Moran. Emilia Soriana. Robert Stewart. Stephen Stewart III. Joshua Suniga. Santiago Suniga Villegas. Jonathan Tedros. Alex Teckley. Esteban Telez. Finit Termillion. Shefu Thompson III. Kevin Thompson Jr. Ariane May Tu. Talili Tolosa. Erica Torres. Lee Trong. Philip Trong. Joanna Timbides. Jean Paul Tuazon. Rafid Reed Yula. Emily Umansor. Anene Daniel Uwanamoto. Charmaine Van Kirk. Jordan Vanderwolf. Daniel Vargas. Justin Vasquez. Eric Velasquez. Juan Ventura. Kevin Ventura. Brendy Vigil. Stephanie Vigil. Eric Vigil Rivera. Adonai Villalta. Francisco Villegas. One second. Giovanni Walters. Cassandra Washington. Benjamin Watkins. Tatiana Watkins. Anthony Williams. Jamali Willie. Ephra Wadaj. Frazier Workina. Natnael Yaji. Malat Yigriamachu. Yosis Yilma. Brunel Younga. Edwin Zavala. Irma Zelaya. Lillian Cepeda. Jose Zuniga. Nicholas Langott. Thank you.
They said don't wait. They don't have time. Ready? Will the class of 2017 please stand?
I'm so drunk. Closer in the backseat. Oh, so slow. I'm over this other conversation. Trust me, I'll get a chance. Now take my hands so
I'm cuando viene. Tengo la cintura, rodilla, piso, dale, ay, pase bien.
Te suspeto light, that's a no, that's a no. Roman, stress. in that room. The Raj, my guys, that's the bro code.
Yeah. That's funny! feeling. Baby, I knew about it. I just didn't care. You just don't understand how much I love you, do you? I'm here for you. I'm not out to go out there and cheat all night. Just like you did, baby, but that's alright. I love you anyway. I'm still gonna be here for you till my dying day, baby. Right now, I'm just in so much pain, baby, because you just won't come back to me.